is for an annexation of a one-lot subdivision that is just outside Hunter Chase subdivision. It is a one-lot development. It is contiguous by the entrance of Hunter Chase, so we are not creating any islands or anything. I do have the owners of the property here if you may have any questions. Since it is a 100% owned petition, I'm sure y'all are aware of the construction prices. So if y'all will keep that in mind when we move this, if it's voted on to move to the full meeting, then I'm sure we want to move forward on this as quick as possible. So if y'all have any questions, I can answer anything.
Again, as Laura said, this is a petition. That means that the owners of the property are petitioning the city to be annexed. It's a very simple process when it's a petition dealing this event. And the petition is one of the few ones that we can waive the second and third reading on to move it forward, since it is a petition method, which means that the owners have already agreed to it. It's already been through all the proper channels and everything. Ben, I'm sure that you have looked this over. Does it meet all the current state statutes and city ordinances?
Yes, sir, it does. I have looked it over. We've talked to GIS office at the state level. They have also looked it over, and everything has been complied.
So everything is good. There's not any issues. Anybody got any questions to Laura or to Ben about this?
Laura, this property wasn't owned by the same property owner when that original land mass was for that subdivision was brought in?
This actual piece of property was not part of Hunter Chase subdivision, and no, it was not.
Is the entrance going to be on Highway 321 or Hunter Chase?
The entrance to the development or the lot?
The lot.
It'll be entered off of Hunter Chase.
And Hunter Chase has approved that?
Well, but it's not part of the Hunter Chase subdivision. So that road is, they have access to that road because it's contiguous with that road.
So right before the gate is where you go in, or after the gate?
Hi, I'm Amanda Kincaid. Ken and I are the property owners, and what we were explained by the attorneys in the state is that the gate, Hunter's Chase really wouldn't have an option. They could move their gate, or they could, I mean, they have to give us the code because our property runs, the gate is at the beginning of that property. So anybody that owns that property has access to their property from that gate. So the address, if it's annexed in, has to be Hunter's Chase Drive, because that's what's in the city limits. If it's on, is that 320 Mount Carmel, that's county.
So for it to be in the city limits, you have to use Hunter Chase?
Because that's what it touches. Hunter Chase is what it's touching in the city limits. But it doesn't affect any other property around it.
So Laura, just looking at the map, and I mean, you might have